My name is Lexi Kay, and I'm one of your Chief Justices for Court of Appeals this year. My favorite YAG memory is getting to know people from all across the state that I wouldn't have met without YAG. And my favorite TikTok dance is the water splash dance from last summer's TikTok.
Big boys stay back, swag surf, wave cap, parking sticker, handicap, swagger bag, fanny pack, candy girl, throw it back, H2O, water splash.
Hey y'all, I'm Susanna Seagrave. My favorite YAG moments are when God's Plan is played across the speakers because it's beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful. And my favorite TikTok dance is going to be played right now.
Carol Baskin killed her husband, whacked him. Can't convince me that it didn't happen. Fed him to tigers, they snacking. What's happening? Carol Baskin.
Hi everyone, my name is Ashley Daniel, and my favorite YAG moment is probably freshman year Friday fun night. And here is my favorite TikTok dance.
We're fighting in the grocery store, and I love you, but I don't know if I like you anymore. And we're running through the city in an August thunderstorm. You drive me crazy, but at least I'm never bored.
Hi, I'm Samantha Webb, and I'm a senior at West Carteret High School. I'm one of your associate justices this year. My favorite YAG memory is that I have too many favorites and can't pick one. And my favorite TikTok is...
Gotta take the time to cut them off, I need her. I know how to make the girl go crazy. When you treat her like your number one baby.
Hey everyone, I'm Nicole Belcher, and I'm one of your associate justices. I'm a senior in the NRC delegation, and my favorite YAG memory was last year's All-Star round in Court of Appeals.
I think I'm falling in love. She said, what you know about love?
I tell you everything.
I got what you need. Woke up in the store and get what you want. Go get. You get what you please. We about to get it on.
Hey everyone, I'm Serena Horner. I'm a junior at Forsyth Country Day School, and I'm one of your associate justices. And my favorite YAG memory is going to the dances with my friends.
I got muscles like Superman trainer. Ooh. Real rare like Super Saiyan Mega. I stomp on Lucifer Sage. Now I got a few rings on Jupiter skating.
Hi, I'm Ann Hadley Griffin, and I'm a junior at West Carteret High School, and I'm one of your associate justices this year. My favorite YAG memory is playing bingo on Saturday night with all of my friends, and my favorite TikTok dance is What You Know About Love.
I think I'm falling in love. She said, what you know about love?
I tell you everything.
I got what you need. Woke up in the store and get what you want. Go get. You get what you please.
Hi, my name is Sophia Mazaros. My favorite YAG memory would have to be winning my first Court of Appeals case. It's really nice seeing your hard work pay off. My favorite TikTok dance is The Renegade.
Hey guys, my name is Lindsay Cobb. I'm a senior at West Carteret High School, and I'm one of your associate justices this year. My favorite YAG memory is meeting all my best friends from throughout the entire state, and my favorite TikTok dance is...
When I'm telling, keep it drama free.
Hello everyone, my name is Brooks Mind, and I'm one of your 2020-2021 Chief Justices. My favorite YAG memory is from last year when my friend Amir Shaheen went up on stage and crushed Connor Cabot in the governor debates. Although I'm not doing this by choice, the justice team has forced me to tell you that my favorite TikTok dance is The Renegade, and I will now be performing that against my free will.
Wait.
Hi everybody, and welcome to Court of Appeals, which is the best branch of youth and government. I know things are going to be a little different and weird this year, but I promise that everything will be just as much fun and that you'll learn just as much as you have in the past. My name is Lexi Kay, and I'm one of the Chief Justices for Youth and Government this year. I've participated in Court of Appeals as an attorney for 2 years, I served as an Associate Justice last year, and I've also participated in the National Judicial Competition for 2 years.
My name is Brooks Mann, and I'm one of your Chief Justices this year. I spent 2 years competing in North Carolina Court of Appeals and also competed in Court of Appeals at a national level twice. Last year, I served as one of the Associate Justices. Although you may be confused or overwhelmed about what you'll have to do at conference this year, if you review this guide as well as some of the other Court of Appeal materials we'll be sending out this year, it will help you along your journey towards writing a good brief for conference.
Today, Brooks and I are going to be telling you some of the 10 best tips that we have for getting started in Court of Appeals so that you guys can be ready and prepared whenever conference comes in February.
With that in mind, here are the top 10 things you'll need to know for this year's conference of Court of Appeals at Youth in Government.
Our 10th tip for you guys is to choose a partner that you know that you can work well with. In Court of Appeals, in order to lessen the workload and make sure that things run smoothly, you're expected to work with a partner from your delegation. If you can't find a partner from your delegation, reach out and let us know and we can match you with somebody else from the state. You will work with your partner from the moment that you start getting the case materials all the way up until conference and possibly even beyond then. Because of this, it's crucial that you pick a partner that you know will carry their load of the work. If they don't, you're stuck with twice as much work to do, so make sure that you keep this in mind whenever you pick your co-counsel.
Number 9. Start as soon as possible and plan ahead. Although there's a lot of work for you and your partner to do this year, writing 4 total briefs, if you get started as soon as possible and divide up the work well, you'll make sure that you get all that work done before conference. A brief is a formal document in which you'll persuade a court to adopt your position. There are 2 different cases, each with an appellant's side, the party appealing the decision of the former court, and a respondent's side, the party defending the decision of the former court.
Our 8th tip to remember is that all cases and case materials are considered closed cases. What this means is that you may only use the materials given to you when writing your briefs. You can obviously still do things such as paraphrase, use basic logic, and write in your own words, which we strongly encourage for all of your analysis and arguments. However, you're prohibited from using outside research, outside cases, and outside materials in your brief. Everything that you've already been given on the NCYAG Court of Appeals website will help you write a successful and strong brief.
Number 7, read over the case multiple times before you start writing. Although it can be exciting to get right into the brief and start writing, it's best to look over the case multiple different times before you begin. You should go over it with 2 different color highlighters to look at what arguments and what evidence you can use for either side. Make sure that you and your partner go over this phase together so you can share information and divide up the work well. Try to get a good idea of what the case is about, as well as main precedent cases that help support each side and the key legal issues that you'll be arguing in your briefs.
Our 6th tip is to make sure that you're staying organized with your writing. When writing your briefs, you must follow a specific format which will help you stay organized. The formatting is simple and a template can be found on the NCYAG Court of Appeals website. In short, your brief should have a formatted title page as well as a table of contents for your reference. Next, you should have a statement of legal issues, of which you can find the legal issues in the briefs and the case materials that we give you. After that, you should include a brief statement of facts or a general overview of your case. You won't be expected to read this by many of the justices, but it's very important for you to have it so that you can make sure that you have the adequate background for the case. Next comes your argument, which is structured around the constitutional issues that you've been asked to argue. You should then finish your brief with a short conclusion where you restate your points very briefly and ask the court to either overturn or keep the previous decision. Finally, make sure that you cite any of the case law that you've used in your brief.
Number 5. Show due respect to the justices and you, in turn, will be respected. With Court of Appeals, there's a lot about presentation and being formal. When you go into your round, it's best to make sure to address the justices with respect. And we're not doing this just because we're vain or because we want to hear this, but instead it's because we're trying to make this process as realistic as possible. This means that you might have to follow courtroom procedure, which includes things like addressing justices as Your Honor or Your Honors, standing when we enter the room, and generally just treating the justices with respect. If you do this and respect those around you, you in turn will also be respected.
Our 4th tip for you guys is to make sure that you're never arguing your opinion or the facts in a courtroom. Make sure that you're arguing the underlying constitutional or legal issues. Court of Appeals is part of the appeals court system. What this means is that it's no longer our duty to argue over issues such as whether the defendant is guilty or not guilty, or any other issues that you would expect to see argued in a civil or criminal courtroom. Instead, the issues that we debate in Court of Appeals generally revolve around constitutional violations, such as breaches of individual rights. For example, the court may debate issues such as whether or not the appellant had a fair, unbiased trial. This means that you should try your best to only argue over the legal issues presented to you and stray away from getting too bogged down in facts or opinions that you have about the case.
This can lead to your argument being less professional and less able to be well executed in the courtroom.
Number 3, practice reading your briefs aloud with a timer. When you show up to conference, you should have an idea about how long each of your briefs will take to read. Timing is very, very important in Court of Appeals. You should use as much of that 10 minutes as possible, and the best way to ensure that you use your time wisely is to record your cases in advance to try to get a rough idea of how long it will take you to read it. This will also help you with things like your pronunciation, as well as your speed of reading and your poise.
Our second tip is to make sure that you're using as much case law as possible. While case law may sound like a confusing concept, it's actually surprisingly simple. Case law consists of precedent cases, or past Supreme Court cases, that set a certain standard that the court must take into consideration. It is your job as a Court of Appeals attorney to embed this case law into your briefs. You should explain how the past Supreme Court cases should be interpreted in the context of the case at hand. Then explain how this helps your side. Case law is crucial to a good Court of Appeals brief, as when it is used effectively, it can demonstrate your knowledge of the case. Most Court of Appeals rounds at YAG boil down to who uses the most case law and who uses it the most effectively to help their argument, so make sure that any case law that can help your case is in your argument.
Number 1. Don't be afraid to ask for help. Although this process can be intimidating, keep in mind that you're not in this process alone. You have 10 justices who are all completely ready to answer questions and help you along the way, and we're so excited to help. We're gonna reach out in the future with things like office hours, when we might make a Zoom call where you could check in with us to see if you need help with your briefs and see what directions you can take to help make your briefs better. We're so excited to help, and our email addresses will be shared out to you. Don't be afraid to ask for help.